How strong is a grizzly bear compared to other bears? There are 8 different species of bear in the world, and yet when someone says bear, 9 times out of 10 you think of a brown bear. There are 15 subspecies of brown bear, and when you see a brown bear, you usually think grizzly bear. The grizzly bear is one of the most well-known animals in the world because, well, look at him. He's enormous, he exudes confidence and ferocity. What could stop this guy? Anything? Any other bears up to the task? You might be surprised by a neighbor of his that's up to the challenge, and another bear far away that's so scrappy, he could put up a fight. But first, don't forget to subscribe. That way you can watch us compare the strength of the grizzly bears with the other bears from a safe distance. Because it's about to get dangerous. Grizzly bears. Brown bears are found throughout Asia, Europe, and North America. But if you're looking for the grizzly bear, he's only in the northwestern portion of North America, Alaska, Canada, Montana, Idaho, and a few other states in the US. Grizzlies can be over 8 feet in length and over 800 pounds easily, but the closer they get to the coast, the larger they get. Especially grizzlies in Alaska, they can eclipse 1,000 pounds. This is often due to their high intake of fatty salmon. People often get this idea of grizzlies being on the pescatarian diet, eating nothing but seafood, spending all day by the river scooping out salmon. Yes, they love fish, but they'll eat plenty of other things. Besides tubers and berries and plants, they will scavenge carcasses and hunt other animals, and they can take down animals as large as deer, elk, bison, even a moose. Grizzlies will chase their prey and oftentimes swing with their powerful paws, and depending on the size of the ungulate, they could break the spine with one swipe. It's happened. They tend to knock the prey over, jump on top, and clamp down with powerful jaws to finish the job. 1,160 pounds per square inch of force in that bite, one of the strongest bites in the world. Grizzlies are a terror in North America, so how strong are they compared to one of their neighbors, the American black bear? American black bear. That's right, the American black bear has tons of overlap with the grizzly bear. In addition to living in the same areas of Alaska, Canada, Montana, Idaho, and other grizzly bear locations, the American black bear is found as far south as California and Florida, and even as far east as New Hampshire and Maine. They're fast, able to run at 30 miles per hour, they're excellent at climbing trees, and they're strong. You do not want to run into a black bear. More than 6 feet long, over 500 pounds, they don't just kill animals, they can kill humans. Their range in North America is vast, their numbers are so high, however they're not as much of a threat to humans as grizzlies. Black bears are the most abundant bear in all of North America, but grizzly bears account for twice as many human deaths. Because a black bear is a scary thing to see if you're a small mammal or a bird, but a grizzly bear is also a scary thing to see if you're a small mammal or bird, or a black bear. In many cases, the grizzly will be twice the weight of the black bear. He can lift and drag his own weight, and maybe even slightly more. A black bear comes with a ferocious bite of 800 psi, but that pales in comparison to the grizzly's bite and even his mouth size. The grizzly might be able to get half the black bear's head in his mouth. That's a bad day to be a black bear. In fact, when food is scarce, the grizzly looks at the American black bear as an alternative meal. Pretty hard to win a fight as the black bear when you are considered food. Asian black bear. America isn't the only place with a black bear. Throughout much of Asia, there is also the Asian black bear, the 4th largest bear species in the world. Asian black bears are slightly smaller than their American cousins, just about 6 feet long, 400 to 450 pounds, but their bite is a bit stronger. They're also excellent climbers and have powerful, well-developed forelimbs that they use to pull themselves into the tree branches. Asian black bears are similar in many ways, also quick on the ground, hitting 25 or even 30 miles per hour in short bursts. They feed on many small mammals and birds as well. Their heads are larger than the American black bear's, which complements that stronger bite quite well. Their claws are strong and curved, which assist with climbing, reaching 1 to 2 inches in length. But we have a problem here. The maximum claw length for an Asian black bear is the minimum claw length for a grizzly bear. Try 2 to 4 inches on those big old paws. Hey, the Asian black bear is dangerous. He's a fighter, but he's going to get torn to shreds if he faces off against a grizzly bear. He should be thankful he's far off in Asia. Sun bear. Speaking of bears in Asia, let's talk about one of the others. Four species of bear in Asia, and one is the sun bear. You'll find them in Southeast Asia, in tropical rainforests of places like Thailand, Cambodia, Vietnam, Indonesia, and several other countries. The sun bear is stockily built with large paws and strong curved claws, which he uses to climb trees and tear apart at the bark in order to obtain food sources. And he has one other attribute that no other bear can rival: his claim to fame. Of all bear species, the sun bear has the longest tongue. It isn't much when it comes to comparing the strength, but it serves him well when he's trying to pull insects out of the trees. The other claim to fame that the sun bear doesn't want to get leaked, especially if a grizzly is around, is that he is the smallest bear species in the world. Still, he's about 100 to 150 pounds when fully grown. He's got some strength. It's just nothing that would translate to taking down a grizzly bear. He isn't nearly as aggressive either, typically shy and staying away from humans and predators alike. You might think the smallest bears have no chance against a grizzly. Well, not so fast. That may not be entirely true. Do you remember we mentioned a bear that lives far away from the grizzly bear, who is incredibly scrappy? He might have something to say about all this. Sloth bear. Meet the sloth bear. Calling him scrappy may not do him justice. He is lethal. He may not be huge, but he is the definition of putting a lot in a smaller package. They're about 4.5 to 6 feet long and will weigh 200 to 300 pounds. Not quite a grizzly, right? But there's something about the sloth bear you should know. He is not only the most aggressive bear in the world, he is also responsible for the most human kills of any other bear, by far. He's a menace. Sloth bears are primarily found in India, and unfortunately for the Indian population, many people have died at the lethal paws of a sloth bear. You're probably thinking, but it's a sloth bear. Isn't it slow? It may be the slowest of all bears, but it's not slow. It's faster than any human, able to run 20 miles per hour. So why is the sloth bear so dangerous? Because he's been thrown into the fire and told the only way out was to defend himself. Sloth bears not only have constant encroachment on their habitats by humans and need to act defensively, but they also have plenty of run-ins with the largest and most dangerous feline in the world, the tiger. And guess what? Sloth bears hold their own. Usually if a tiger and a sloth bear meet, the tiger wins the battle. But we said usually. Not always. There have been documented cases of a sloth bear overpowering and killing a tiger. So yes, a sloth bear is a defensive, dangerous, strong, biting, clawed, hand-swiping maniac who can put the hurt on anyone. He could defend himself against a grizzly. However, the grizzly fights the same way, and he's just much stronger. Give credit to the smaller bear from India, but he won't consistently overtake a grizzly. But we have a feeling someone closer to home might be able to. Panda bear. We've got a lot of opinions about panda bears as a society. At first glance, they look like big, cuddly, stuffed animals the way they playfully interact with their environment. But don't forget, the panda is a bear. There's been instances of people getting too close to the bars that enclose panda bears, and a panda latching onto the person and putting his strength on display. Maybe the panda only wanted to steal the person's jacket, but that didn't mean the person didn't go through a harrowing and hurtful experience. So yes, you stand no chance against a panda bear, assuming you watching this are a human. If you're a grizzly bear, don't worry, the panda is much smaller, and you, Mr. Grizzly, you are much stronger. Pandas are 4 to 5 feet long and usually 220 to 260 pounds. They primarily eat bamboo and rarely eat any meat, only occasionally found hunting small rodents. They lack the strength and aggressiveness that is inherent to that of a grizzly. A grizzly would dominate a panda, but seeing as how pandas live in China, we hadn't yet got close enough to home to find a neighbor that was a suitable challenger. Maybe we need to head on over to South America. Spectacled bear. Yes, most bears live on the continents of North America, Europe, and Asia, but there's one who lives near the grizzly, one bear who lives in South America, the spectacled bear. Spectacled bears have muscular necks and powerful arms, which assist them in climbing the many trees in their habitats. They are the most arboreal of all bears, truly phenomenal climbers, which just shows you how strong they are. They're mainly herbivorous, but their power and agility makes them successful predators when they're hunting for animals on the ground or in the trees. But they work won't scare a grizzly. A spectacled bear is a horror show for a rabbit or a rodent, but not for the much larger grizzly. Spectacled bears are only 4 to 6 feet long, usually between 300 and 450 pounds. Not only are they about half the weight of a grizzly, their bite force is also half of a grizzly's. Half is not a good fraction to be at. The grizzly might bite the spectacled bear right in half. So if it isn't this neighbor of the grizzlies that would put up a fight, then who is it? Polar bear. Ah yes, the polar bear. Now we found a proper match for the grizzly bear. When ranking all the species of bears, polar bears are larger than brown bears on average. However, the grizzly bear is larger than the average brown bear. Like we said, over 8 feet long, over 1,000 pounds. That happens often enough. How about his cousin up north? Polar bears are built in a more slender fashion. Adult males are usually 8 to 10 feet long and will weigh 1,200 pounds. Then again, some have gotten to 1,700. The polar bear gets to be the largest land carnivore in the world, partially due to all the fatty meats he consumes from seals and walruses, but he's no slouch. He can run 25 miles per hour and even swim 6 miles per hour. They can lift and drag prey that weighs 2,000 and even 3,000 pounds. In many cases, polar bears may possess more strength. Then again, they're built more slender, whereas a grizzly bear is more robust. A battle between the two could go either way. Both are titans of strength. And don't forget about that grizzly bite, 1160 psi, one of the strongest in the animal kingdom. Almost as strong as the polar bear bite, 1200 psi. Both of these bears could put the hurt on one another. One thing is for sure, if a grizzly bear and a polar bear engage in a fight, stand clear. You don't want to get caught up near that. In the end, the polar bear is usually stronger, but the grizzly is a more muscular and robust specimen oftentimes. He's faster too. He's a perfect killing machine. But his neighbor up north is the toughest challenge he could ever face.